Blackstone presents House of the Patriarch by Barbara Hambly. This book is read by Ron Butler. To Harry and Laura. 1.
Our daughter is missing.
The tall Englishman spoke quietly, but Benjamin January, sitting opposite him across the empty fireplace, saw his long fingers twitch as he drew out a letter and an octavo-sized square of what looked like brown cardboard from his breast pocket. His wife, short and snub-nosed, with the air of a woman supremely in charge of her life, turned her face away quickly, and January saw her tears. As January held out his hand, his eyes met, for a moment, those of his own wife, standing beside her. Rose always looked collected, but behind the lenses of her spectacles, he saw the same painful division of mind and heart that he knew she saw in him. He had just come back from another journey, another job, that had nearly cost him his life. The bullet graze in the muscles of his back was barely healed. And they really, really needed money. Damn it, thought January. Damn it, damn it. He took the papers. He was to spend the next 7 weeks kicking himself for doing so. From the couch on the other side of the parlor, Henri Viellard spoke up.
I told Mr. Russell of the remarkable success you had in finding our friend Mr. Singletary in Washington City a few years ago.
January was tempted to mutter, Ibn al-Harim, his first wife's favorite indelicate expression when annoyed. But mindful that he was speaking to a white man, he only inclined his head and said,
You're very kind, sir.
And in fact, he was. January's relationship with the Viellards. Chloë Viellard sat next to her husband, like a bespectacled schoolgirl in her plain gray dress, was one of those arrangements impossible to explain to anyone not born and raised in New Orleans. When the Viellard Family Corporation had forced Henri to marry his cousin Chloë, Henri had already been the protector of January's lovely youngest sister, Dominique, making Henri, in a sense, January's brother-in-law, or brother-outlaw, given the fact that Louisiana law forbade Henri to marry even the fairest of creme café quadroons like Dominique, no matter how much he loved her. Henri's note earlier that morning had said that English friends, connections of the private bank with which the extremely wealthy Viellards did business, had need of the kind of assistance that January might be able to render. Would it be convenient for him to bring them to January's house? January unfolded the letter.
New York, Thursday, 11 June, 1840.
Paget. My poor cousin. There's no way to say this except to say it. Eve has disappeared. She spent a week with the Delaports in Kings Point, and was returning by way of the steam packet on Monday with not only Lucy, but Andy, the Delaport's coachman.
January guessed that Lucy must be her maid, since young ladies of the Russell's class didn't undertake journeys alone. He glanced up from the shaken scrawl to meet Paget Russell's grief-racked blue eyes.
She disappeared while staying in New York then, sir?
The Englishman nodded.
Eve wouldn't. That is...
Mrs. Russell, hovering at his shoulder, put in,
Eve asked if she could remain in New York with my cousin's family, the Winterinks. They're related to the Brevoorts, you know, rather than traveling with us to New Orleans. We saw no reason why it should not be so. Eve was a great success in New York society.
She pressed her kid-gloved hand quickly to her lips, as if to still their sudden unsteadiness.
Why, she was invited to stay with the Gunsforts in Saratoga County. And one of the Livingston boys stood up with her, twice, at the Brevoorts' ball.
She spoke the names of the wealthy New York families with the same reverence January had heard in the voice of Henri Viellard's mother when she referred to the aristocratic French families who ruled New Orleans society, the Mandevilles and Metoyers and Blancs.
And Mrs. Livingston told me.
Her husband reached back to touch her hand gently, silencing her.
We received this letter only yesterday, he said.
I have no idea what my cousin's family has done so far, or what the police might have learned, but I cannot. We cannot.
3 weeks for the letter to get here.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.